welcome to our YouTube channel. We are Group 29 and we are here to educate you on how to derive complete records from incomplete records. We'll be using a raw data we collected from Moscow phones to educate you on this. Stay tuned. From the inquiries we made from the man, he said that it has been in existence for more than 12 years and that is why he continues. Well, some accounts we used and prepared in this process is one, statement of affairs. Statement of affairs helps us to identify the capital, the opening capital for the period. The second one is nominal ledgers. These are accounts we open to transfer single entry to double entry. The third one is income statement. Income statement helps us to identify the profit or loss for the period. And then our statement of financial position helps us to ascertain the financial position of the business, whether the business is liquidating. When I say liquidating, meaning it's coming to an end, or the business has a strong firm in its financial position. The last one is a report, which summarizes everything that's transpired from the beginning to the end.
These are the list of balances that we used in preparing our previous accounts. These are the list of balances extracted from Moscow Funds Enterprise. And these are his assets and liabilities as at 19 June 2023. Furniture 500, fixtures and fittings 5,000, inventory for the opening 19,516 and for the closing 17,214. Cash in hand 1,337, credit says 300, and his other transactions include cash sales 4,761, home sales 322, cash paid to credit says 60. He drew cash to Mr. Asani 192, cash payment, this includes door maintenance 150, electricity 50, general expense 77, and cleaning 65. These are the photos of transactions that were taken from Moscow phones on Monday, Tuesday, and on Wednesday.
We are preparing our statement of affairs as at 19 June 2023. So the statement of affairs basically is based on the accounting equation. That's the assets, minus the liabilities, and we get to our capital. So first, we have our assets. The first one is the furniture. So furniture, we have $500. Then furniture and fixtures, we have $5,000. Then inventory, we had $19,561. Then our cash in hand was $1,337. Then so that made our total assets. That's 26,398. Next, we left our liabilities. We have our parent debts, 398. Lastly, our capital, that's 26,098.
So, I'll take you to the nominal ledgers. With Moscow phones, it was recorded all his transactions, only the cash. So we have to prepare the double entry for the cash, like corresponding ledgers or account.
So the cash book on the credit side, we recorded creditors as 60. So when you come to your creditors, the creditors account, the corresponding will be for the ledger side as cash, 60. When you come to drawings, we recorded 190 on the credit side. When you come to drawings account, we debit it with 190. Then you take your maintenance, you record it 150. You go to your maintenance account, you debit it with 150. Electricity, you record it 50. You go to electricity account, debit side 50. Then you come to general expenses, you record it 77 on the credit side. So the corresponding general expenses account, with debit cash with 77. Then we sum on the credit side, sales was 4,761. So the corresponding sales account on the credit side, you cash 4,761. Then sum it up. Your balance carry down will be on credit side as 5,506. And then you bring it to the debit side. In Bosco Foods, you also accepted me. So you made Bongo sales of 322, which is at the, so you credit it at so on the sales account with Momo as 322. Then you go to Momo account, you debit Momo account with 322. So after that, you come to your cash account, you balance it from the
was recording these transactions on a single entry basis. friendly
and a nice gentleman, a literate as well. So it wasn't very difficult for us to get access to this transaction, to prepare the various accounts, ascertain his final statement of final position
for the week ending
24th of June 2024.
So since Moscow phones were on single end, we faced the following difficulties. Firstly, it was difficult to extract the dry balance. Secondly, the preparation of the various financial statements were very difficult. The income statement and the statement of financial position. And third, it was difficult for us to detect any errors in the transaction that have been presented to us.
This is how far the Lord has brought us. My colleagues have taken you through the various accounts, that's the statement of affairs, the nominal ledger, the income statement, and the statement of financial position. Reverend Taki, thank you very much for introducing us to the practical aspect of our academia. Thanks to my fellow colleagues for their massive support in the preparation of accounts. Thank you all for watching this channel. Bye-bye.